If you keep on following data dependencies and control dependencies, starting from a given statement, the set of statements which you get, that is, the set of statements that possibly could have influenced the statement in question, is also called a program slice. A so-called backward slice, starting from a statement, contains all the statements that the statement S in question would transitively depend upon. You obtain a backward slice by starting with the statement S and then following all the dependencies until you have reached a fixed point. The interesting thing about slices is that anything that's not in the slice cannot have influenced the state at the statement S or whether S is being executed or not. Therefore, a slice can act as a filter. Let me illustrate this by an example. As an example, let's take a look at the statement tag is true. This is our statement S. Now let's see what's all contained in the slice of tag. First of all, there's no direct data dependency because no variable is being read in here. However, this is control dependent on this if condition. This if condition again is dependent on the character C, so this is also part of the backward slice. And this condition up here reads from the variable S, which is passed as a parameter up here, so this is also part of the backward slice. Now let's go to quote. Where does quote come from? It is being initialized up here and set down here. So we end up in the place where quote is being set. Now, can you keep on doing this, completing the backward slice of S? One by one, check all statements that are part of the backward slice.